Hey, what's up, guys? Glock9 here, and welcome back to Cabin in the Woods. It is the morning of day 26, and the first thing I want to do is spend some skill points here. We've got five of them, so I'm going to go into agility twice, and then with the last point, I'm going to max out flurry of blows. All right, let's get this forge turned on. It's smelting down brass and lead and crafting rebar frames. Some bars, forged iron, and steel. Let's actually get a little bit more fuel in here. And then this forge isn't doing anything because we don't have any stone, so that's what we're going to do now, dig some stone. I also crafted an impact driver last night, but I got my auger on me and some gasoline. So let's get to mining. I don't know why I started mining that way. This is the way we have to go, towards the lake, because there's an iron ore out there, so hopefully we hit it. And while we dig here, I want to share a story with you guys, because yesterday was Veterans Day. Well, this video will air on Friday, so 2 days ago was Veterans Day. And it's about my dad. My dad grew up on President Street in Brooklyn, right across the street from a bar that was owned and operated by the Gallo Boys. Now, if you don't know who the Gallo Boys are, they were a crime family. There's been books written about them. There's been movies made about them. One of them was called The Gang That Couldn't Shoot Straight. Joey Gallo, who was like the main dude over there, he was depicted in the movie The Irishman. So, my dad grew up across the street from these guys. When he was just a kid, they would let him hang out in the workshop behind the bar and build go-karts with his friends. And then they would race the go-karts around the streets of New York, and if the cops started chasing them, they would just lead them back to the bar. And the Gallos would tell the cops to go fuck themselves, and the cops would do exactly that. So he had a relationship with these guys, growing up. And there's a lot of crazy stories that I have that happened back then, but those are for another time. This story takes place when my dad was 18 and got his draft notice for the Vietnam War. Can you imagine being 18 years old and getting a letter in the mail that basically says, pack your shit, you're going to boot camp, and then you go into a foreign country to fight in a war? I mean, he's just a baby at 18. Can't even drink legally. But it was a different time back then. So anyway, a couple of days after my dad got the draft notice, he bumps into Joey Gallo outside the bar, and he's talking to him. And when Joey finds out that my father was drafted, Joey, being the gangster that he is, tells my dad, why the fuck do you want to go fight a bunch of people you don't know for a bunch of people you don't know? So he tells him, listen, you come with us, we'll set you up, you'll get pinched, you won't do any time, we'll get you right out of jail. Oh, look at this, we're hitting nitrate powder. That's cool, hopefully we hit iron, that's what we really need. But anyway, he tells him, listen, you know, you'll get pinched, we'll get you right out, and then you won't have to go. But you have to understand, my dad's dad had been to war, and his grandfather had been to war, so my dad looked at it like, well, now it's my turn, it's my time now. So he turned down Joey Gallo, and he answered the call. And I'll forever be proud of him for that. Because shit, I might not even be here if things would have went the other way. You know what I'm saying? I'm pretty sure I wouldn't be here, because the whole fucking Gallo gang is dead. They all got killed. And now we're hitting lead. That's pretty sweet. So anyway, thank you, Dad, for doing the right thing. And to all you veterans and active service members, thank you all. Stand proud, stay strong, and keep doing the right thing. Well, that wasn't bad. We didn't hit iron, but we did hit nitrate powder and lead, and we got a shit ton of stone right there. So let me throw the auger away and the gasoline. Bring down our pickaxe. We can put away the hammer also, but before we do that, let's get... Wait, I need more cement. Okay, let's grab the sand out of here, get as much concrete mix moving as we can, and then let's make like, 2,000 pieces of sand. That'll be good. And now let's get a bunch of stone smelting down in this forge. All right, now before we leave, there's some work to be done around the cabin, and let's go ahead and get that done now so we're not scrambling later on when we get back home. Whoops. I forgot my steel downstairs, so we'll repair that shit later. But let's get this concrete repaired, and these blocks right here, get those filled in with the rebar frames, And then we got to do the same thing for the rooftop. Fill in all those blocks that the vultures broke last night, get those upgraded, and then put some more spikes on the roof, and we'll be good. At that point, we can hit the road and do some looting. Since I used a bunch of wood on those spikes, let's chop down some trees, sustain some life, and then we'll get out of here. Ah, fuck it, we're going this way today. We always go the other way, and I'm sick of it. Plus, you know what's this way? Gravestown. And you know where Gravestown is? New Jersey. It feels like a New Jersey kind of day, so let's go there. I'm sure we can find some place to raid. It's not too far away, so we don't have to be worrying about rushing home. Plus, we got most of the work done at the cabin already, so we're good. Hey, fuck you, fire guy. You know what's down here in Gravestown? That, Death Hotel. Which, if you watch the first Apocalypse series, you know, didn't end well last time I went there. So maybe we can get some form of redemption today. But here we are, New Jersey. Let's see. Look, it's right here. I already see the silhouette. The Hotel of Death. Oh, fucking bird. Come here, you little bastard. How about a knife in the eye? Yeah. Fuck you too, bear. I'll kill you later, maybe. But yeah, screw it. Let's get in this hotel. We're definitely not going to be able to raid the whole place today. But we'll do what we can until about maybe hour 17. Screw you, Mo. And then we'll get out of here. What the hell is that dog doing? Is he stuck on the spikes? Oh, spear's a bad idea. Here we go. Oh, shit. Doing dumb shit already. Haven't even gotten inside yet. Think we can sneak up on these dogs? Nope. Nope, we can't. There goes one. There goes two. And three. Oh, we're playing sloppy today, man. It's gonna be a sloppy day. I can already tell. Well, that could have went a lot better, I'll tell you that. Let's try and be a little less sloppy moving forward. I'm gonna scrap the can and I'm gonna scrap the auger for the machine tool parts because I used all the machine tool parts I had last night to make this impact driver. Wake up, Big Mama. Got a little reception area right here. Let's check the file cabinet. Scrap the lead trophy, take the paper. I can hear a zombie beating on something, but I'm sure it's probably coming from outside. Maybe a zombie just trying to beat his way in to this place. I'm not taking the murky water. We can scrap that, eat the food, and scrap the can. Let's keep it moving here. Bookshelf. Oh, look at that. Man, I was just talking about the SMG in the last episode, and now we find the schematic. That's fucking sweet. Oh, we can make that as soon as we get back home. Nice, man. And you know, that's funny because someone was saying in the comments of the last video that you have to, as far as they can tell, you have to find the schematic and build the SMG. All right, I don't see any zombies or anything out there, so I'm not going to worry about it. So I don't know if that's true, whether you have to build it or if you can possibly find it. But either way, we found the schematic, so we're good. Look at this. This level 1 machete is way better than the level 6 hunting knife. All right, I'll hang on to that. Now, I think we got a little bit more loot down here. Let's take the chance. Hopefully, we don't wake any zombies up. Nothing in the purse. All right. Wake up, Big Mama. Let's have some fun with her. Oh, look at that. As soon as she jumped up. That just gave me an idea. What if we put this guy on the steps leading up to us in the cabin? Like, right on the steps. Because she's still trying to jump up here. Oh, shit, she got up. What the fuck are you doing, Sledgy? Did you take a break? Alright, forget that idea. Now, give me that loot bag. Okay, I'll take that. It was a football player in the bathroom. See if we can grab this shit without waking him up. Anything in here? No? Okay, come on out of there, football player. Oh, Big Mama too. Damn it. No shit. God damn it, Thick. Sneaking up on me. Is this bedroom clear? It is. Got a wall safe right here. All right, let's do it. Ooh, auto shotgun. It's only a level 1, though. Let me look at those stats real quick. 10 and 10, 20 and 10. All right, so it's not as good as the level 5 pump, which I didn't think it would be. You dead lady? Yeah. But it's still pretty cool that we found one. So hopefully we'll find a better one soon, or the schematic, and we can just craft one. The schematic would be better, because then we can craft a level 5. Nice, and I'm assuming there are no more zombies in this little apartment, so let's do the kitchen, then there's one more bedroom, and then we'll move on. And I think we're making pretty good time, but like I was saying earlier, we'll bail probably around hour 17 or so. And then we can always come back tomorrow and get the main stash, and then maybe loot something else in this town. Heist book. Let's check that out. Adrenaline fall. You can fall up to 15 meters without taking damage while carrying 5,000 dukes or more. Well, I don't even have 2,000 on me, so that's not going to work out for us right now. That's not a bad book to have. Maybe we just start carrying all of our coin on us from now on, so we don't got to worry about taking fall damage. Look at this. We got a snake is the one beating on the wall here. All right, well, let's get some meat. You don't get much from snakes, but you do get something. Come here, you fucker. Bam. You stay right there, bear. I'm not out here for you. All right, everyone, wake up. Whoa. Not as quick as I am. Let's get the sledgehammer down. Oop. Holy shit, they just pushed their way right through. And we got a radiated zombie in the crowd. Are they dead? You all dead? Man, you gotta love how like shit just hits the fan so quick in this game. Alright, now, this room... Is this the room where you fall through the floor into the death room? Or is that higher up? I don't remember. I'm pretty sure the floor in this room gives out. I just don't know if that's the death room down there or not. Either way, I'm gonna try not to fall down there. Some gunpowder. I don't know if the floor gives out right here or not. Oh, yeah, it does. Let's just do this. All right, we made it. I'm pretty sure that wasn't the death room down there, though. I think that's a bit higher up. Here we go. Back up. Close this door. Shit. Now we should have zombies up here and right here. They're waking up. Let's do the same thing. It's just a couple of them. No big deal, but you never know what you're going to get in this room. Sometimes cops spawn in here. You know, I was thinking we might get another radiated zombie. We're okay. Was just taking some precautions. Let's clear this room. An ammo pile up here. Nice. Alright, I'll take the armor. Forget the boots. And you know what I was thinking? If we crafted this SMG when we got home, it'd just be a level 1. We need to put skill points into, I believe Gunslinger. Even though it says pistols, you need pistol parts to craft the SMG. I mean, we can find out right now. There we go. Now we should be able to craft a level 2 SMG. We can. Beautiful. Alright, so you know what we're going to do? We're going to get through the horde tonight. And then with all the skill points that we earn tonight during the horde, we got a radiated zombie right here. Told you. Wake up. Oh, she fell. That was cool. Oh, she getting up. She didn't fall all the way through the floor. Back up, big mama. All right, get back in that hole. There we go. Perfect. So yeah, with all the skill points that we earn tonight during the horde, we'll put those into Gunslinger, get that up to like level 4 or 5, and then we'll be able to craft a level 5 SMG, and that'll be sweet. So we won't be able to use the SMG for tonight's horde, but granted we survived tonight, we'll have one for tomorrow. Oops, waking up more. Oh, shit. Where are you going, buddy? Ran right past me. Waking up a whole bunch more. All right, that guy's dead. So are these two. What do we got up here? An ammo pile. Oh, level 2 junkie. And they're breaking through the wall right here. Let's help them out. Yeah, come on out of there. All right. We're clear. Anything in this bedroom? There's some trash in the corner. Scrap the brass, take the cloth. What's up there? Another ammo pile. Some shells. And I'm good on that green jacket. We're starting to get pretty overloaded here. And it's just past hour 16, so I don't think we're going to be going much further. What's in here? Ah, I think this is the death room. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I mean, not the death room, but this is where the floor gives out and you fall down into the death room, I think. It's only one way to find out, right? I'm kidding. We're not going to do that. Let's avoid that whole area. Matter of fact, let's just loot this room and then probably get out of here. Okay, not much going on in the kitchen. Let's close this door. Challenge. I'll scrap this stuff. Why the hell not? Let's read this challenge. Kill some nurse zombies. Okay, I can do that, but not right now. So I'm going to take it off of the HUD. We got a bunch of challenges piling up. We got a dog at this front door right here. He's going to be breaking through there soon. And from here we have to go up the elevator shaft, which I'm not doing. We'll save that for when we come back here. Got some food up here. Water. Acid and nothing. Just a couple of chairs in here, which I really don't care about. Let's get out of here. We'll go deal with that dog, then we'll get home. We got to repair the iron bars and the steel blocks, then just get geared up and we'll be ready to go. All right, here we go. Same plan as always. Once they break through these bars, we'll get into position. I got a good amount of forged iron, so I think I can hold them off at the bars tonight. But if we run out of forged iron or they just break through the bars, then we'll back up to the steel hatches. And, I mean, we got a radiated zombie right off the bat here. So it's probably going to be a crazy night. I forgot to put the full auto trigger mod on the tactical assault rifle. I just took the mods that were in the AK and put them on this thing. So it kind of sucks with the 3-round burst, but it's not too bad. All right, we gotta go. Sometimes I ask myself, why do we even bother at the front door? But what the hell? It's just one set of iron bars and a hatch, and we do get a decent amount of kills there before they can get inside, so I'm gonna keep doing it. Let's get some fire down there, and let's go fuck them up. What the fuck, you little bastard, how'd you get up here? Man, we are beat up. 68 hit points, we're infected, we got an abrasion. Let's have some honey here. Get rid of that infection, we use a bandage for the abrasion. That'll also give us some hit points back. And let's try not to get our ass kicked so much. Oh, was that the radiated guy that got me right there? It's like they keep getting these cheap hits on me. Like the game is pissed off that I'm kicking the shit out of it. Well, we're using a lot of shotgun ammo tonight. See, that's why I'm hoarding ammo. Oh shit, they almost broke through the bars right there. Good thing I checked. What the fuck? Oh shit, look at this. Son of a bitch, dude. There's a spider zombie on the other side of this wall, reaching through the concrete blocks and hitting me. How cheap is that shit? This game really is pissed off at me for finding all the cheap ways to get hits on me since they can't get through these bars. Shit, I'm gonna have to do something about that. Look at the XP gain right there in the bottom right. 70,000. Fucking spider zombies. 75, 80,000. Oh, let's see. Can we get it to 90? Reload. Come on. 89. 90,000, dude. Are you kidding? 100,000. Holy shit. All right, I think that's it. Other than this spider zombie that's still outside. Can you believe this bullshit? Come here, you fucker. He just sat out here the whole night. Oh, come on, you slippery bastard. Oh, damn it. Another radiated zombie. Come on, you fuckers. This is some bullshit. All right, Mo. Fuck off. Can you believe this spider zombie just hung out here the whole time? Jumping up, getting cheap hits on me? I'm gonna have to do something about that. I don't know what. We can read this treasure map. That's to the northwest. Right up here. And look, we got some POIs right here. That we haven't raided, so that sounds like a plan for tomorrow. Alright, that's it for the loot bags, and that's gonna be it for this episode. I got a couple of things here I can scrap, the boots and this hat. Now we got 6 skill points. Let's go into Gunslinger to level 4, right? Yeah, that'll allow us to craft a level 5 SMG. Bam. Which we will do tonight. So we can start using some of our 9mm ammo for tomorrow night's horde. But that's going to be it for this episode, guys. Let me get all this loot organized, and we'll pick things up here on the morning of day 27. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I hope you're looking forward to seeing more. Thank you so much for watching and all the support. It really does mean a lot. You guys can follow me on Instagram or Twitter. It's at Glock9Gamer. I follow all gamers back. Stick around for more Cabin in the Woods, and I will catch you guys in the next episode.